Brother, I can't. I've got to have the church as long as I'm able to be in the church. But if I can't be in the church and I'm laid up somewhere on my back, praise God, the church can come to me because God will take care of us. But as long as I can go wiggle my toes a little bit, somebody went out this morning, I believe it was Michael's mother, and said, you still got it. Said, you can still run, you can still dance, you can do all those things, and said, you're older than I am. Well, tell me somebody I'm not older than they are. But so she said, I can't even do that. You know why I can do that? It's because my God is in my feet, because beautiful are the feet of those that spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because God is in these toes that I wiggle in my shoes. The God that's in the voice that I have, though sometimes it's weak at my age, and it still can stand and praise and magnify a God of glory, a God of beauty, a God of love, a God of grace, a God of mercy, a God of life, a God of peace, and a God that things are going to be better when this life is over. And yes, hallelujah, Betty and Brenda, the best is yet to come. Praise God, no matter how good it gets. There have been services we've had here in Hickory Grove Church that I've been in them elsewhere when I didn't know if my gravity was going to hold me any longer or not. I just felt the praise and the glory of a holy God sitting on his throne in heaven. The name of Jesus was being profounded before the world, and I just felt big heaven come down, give me a little bit of heaven to go to the big heaven in. And I wondered sometimes, Lord, is this the day? Well, praise God, I want you to know that day is going to come. I can't get that out in the world, but praise God, I can get it when we come together collectively in one place and in one accord. Why do you think Jesus told them to go to Jerusalem and tarry on high? Because they would receive power. Well, the disciples believed what Jesus said. If the disciples needed anything, they needed power to make it, because Jesus was going to go away in a little while. He said, you go there and tarry in Jerusalem, tarry there on high in the upper room. And he said, you'll receive power when the Holy Ghost comes upon you. Well, praise the Lord, they went up in that building. They wasn't out here, one over here. They wasn't one down on the street. They wasn't out there on the weekend somewhere singing a worldly song and saying, I don't need to go to church. But brother, they did what Jesus said. They gathered in one place and in one accord. I believe, Hickory Grove Church, that if we ever have success and get people saved, we're going to have to gather in one place, in one accord, and raise up the name of Jesus over every other god in the world. We're going to have to raise up and say, those gods are dead. Only Jesus Christ is alive. Hallelujah. Praise the name of God tonight. It's good to be in one place, in one accord. I have no argument tonight. Well, I shook hands with everybody that come through that door. I loved them, and I could feel the love coming back. You tell me that you know Jesus Christ and you don't need that. I tell you, I know Jesus Christ, and this preacher needs that. Amen. I've been preaching for 60 years. You say, well, preacher, you ought to be about done by now. Well, I don't know. I'll get done one of these days. And when I do, well, I'll shut up and I'll be home with the Lord. Hallelujah. But until then, I'm going to gather together with God's people. Praise the Lord. How do we show a sinner how great the church is? How do we show an unsaved loved one how much we love God when we don't even go to his house? How can we do that? You cannot do it. But there's people today that are scoffers walking after their own lust. I'm so old, and you all know how old I am, and I've been around a lot of years. But I never seen lust as great as it is today for anything that comes along. Well, you can break every barrier. It doesn't matter what God said. I'm going to have it my way. I'm going to enjoy myself. Brother, you can enjoy yourself in a mess that God didn't make. You can enjoy yourself in affairs and everything else. Men can marry men, women can marry women, or all that sort of thing if they want to. And I pray for them. They just need to get saved. There's nothing in the world. They don't need to see psychiatrists. They need to see Jesus Christ, the Son of a living God, that can change their life. I don't hate people. I love people. But I hate the sin that's in this world today. And I'm going to stand in a pulpit of God as long as I've got breath to breathe and a mouth voice to talk. And I'm going to tell this world that if you die in sin, you'll be resurrected in your sin. And there's no day of forgiveness after this life is over. If you're foolish enough tonight to believe in a purgatory, that there's a place after you die, that you've got another chance, what makes you think you're going to do any better in the sin business after you leave here than what you're here now? Now is the day of salvation. Now is the accepted time. But we've got all this going on in the world today. Now, I know I'm preaching to the choir tonight, but I'm preaching to the choir because the choir's getting smaller. And those of us that are all hanging on, brother, we better dig in a little deeper, hang on a little stronger, or it might be one of us out there saying, I don't need God anymore. I don't need God anymore. I can go off and do whatever I want to, have my worldly pleasure, and then when Jesus comes back, I'll just go up to meet him. I want to tell you tonight, when Jesus comes back, and he is coming, what's it going to be like? God told us what it's going to be like. Now, I know we've got a lot of preaching today, and I preached on it myself. And Jim and I were talking before church, and he said, I got a tape of yours. He said, it's something about the fly in the ointment, and I couldn't remember it either. But I was sitting over here, and it came to me. I tell you what it was, Jim, the title of it was A Fly in the Ointment of the Apothecary. An apothecary is a druggist. That's a pharmacy. I want you to know, in the church of the living God, there's no flies in the ointment. Now, in a church somewhere that's telling you you can sin and get to heaven, in a church somewhere where it's telling you you don't have to confess your sin to be saved, then there might be a lot of flies in that ointment, I tell you that. But in a church of the living God, which is in your heart and in my heart, there's no flies in that ointment. Thank God the flies are gone. They won't even come there because you know where a fly goes? It goes to something that's dirty and filthy and stinks. And brother, let me tell you, when your heart is cleansed by the blood of Jesus Christ, it's not dirty, it's not filthy, and it don't stink anymore. And so the flies don't come into the house of the living God. I'm telling you, oh, glory to God. Thank God there's no flies in the ointment in the house of God. Woo! Thank you, Lord. You don't go putting ointment. Anyway, I move on. Got to hurry. I know what you're talking. But God is a judge. Christ is a judge. There's a last judgment coming. And if I die the next 5 minutes, it'll be for me at that moment. And then there'll be the great judgment day. But the exposure of sin. Now, I don't know about a lot of folk, but I believe the reason that our government is in the shape it's in and is because the churches are in the shape they're in. I should hear something from all the way back there. Huh? If the church is going to live like the world, how do we expect the government not to live? If we okay everything under the sun and we don't support the church, then the government's going to decide, well, they don't care. There's not enough of them to matter anymore. We got a president that says that we're not a Christian nation anymore. Well, I don't know about you, but I still believe in one nation under God. One nation under God. Praise the Lord. And that's not a political statement. You go vote for whoever you want to.